today, what I wanted to quickly do, since my big trip was canceled, I'm gonna break in my rotors. And I'm gonna show you how to break in your new rotors. Because when you replace your rotors, and really, you should, and I did, replace also your brake pads. There's two pads, pad one, two, and then on the back, there's also two pads. When you change your rotors, you might as well change your brake pads. And so that's what I did. And so what we're gonna do today is we're gonna go out probably to Marikina Riverbank because there's some nice straightaways there and it's flat. And that's helpful and important to have a nice straightaway and a relatively flat space where you can go back and forth to break in your pads and your rotors. And so we're gonna go there real quick now, and then when we get on location, I'm gonna tell you what we're gonna do. Okay, before we leave for our event, I'm gonna change my mind because I have a lot of braking to do before we even get to Marikina Riverbank. So, which is not good to be braking when you're not purposely, when you haven't really broke them in properly. So we're just gonna use the highways going that direction for the activity, yeah? And one of the keys in braking in your rotors and your brake pads is when you apply the brake, you do them one at a time, like rear brake, and you never come to a complete stop. So you hit your brake, and then you're rolling while your brake is pressed. So you're purposely pressing your rotors together, but you do not want to come to a complete stop using the brake. And so after you're finished with about 8 to 10 cycles with your rear brake, then you do the same braking in activity with your front brake. Supposedly you're supposed to start with maybe 8 to 10 cycles at 15 kilometers per hour, and then 8 to 10 cycles at a higher speed, like 30, which is pretty fast. And then if you can find one good downhill, you know, to do it, that's even better. But I don't think I'm gonna find a downhill today, and I'm not gonna make the extra effort. We're just gonna do about 8 to 10 cycles on our rear brake and 8 to 10 cycles on our front brake at a moderate speed. And then we're gonna speed up faster. I don't know if we're gonna hit 30 with traffic, etc. And we're gonna do some more cycles with the rear and more cycles with the front. I actually had to start already just coming to this starting spot. I actually finished one cycle already with the rear brake. See, with our traffic here already, I need to do some cycles with my rear brake already. Just obviously because I'm going through this traffic, and it can be done. So right now, ready and press. I'm pressing, but I'm still pedaling. Yep, still pedaling, still pressing. And I'm gonna come a little bit slower and I'm gonna let go. Okay, so that's cycle number two for the rear brake. Here comes cycle three, a mini one. Pressing, letting go. But I'm still moving, all right? I'm not a complete stop. So the goal is no complete stops during the braking in period.
there's a reason. I'll explain it a little bit later. We're gonna take a right up here. So I finished two cycles on my rear brake. Okay, let's catch this traffic. Okay, here we go. Let's shift up a little bit. So that's two cycles. Okay, here comes cycle number three. Pressing the brake right now. I'm still pedaling. Pressing the brake, still pedaling. Pressing the brake. Pressing the brake. And releasing the brake. That's number three. Pressing the brake, pressing the brake, still pedaling, still pedaling. It's hard, but I'm pressing the brake, forcing it. That's number four, release. So we finished four already. It's really tricky for this traffic. But at least if you're conscious of it, okay, I'm gonna press the brake now, just for safety. This is a partial number five. I'm still pedaling barely. Partial number five, I'm gonna go, here we go. That was like a half five. Okay, let's do another half five. Ready and rear brake, pressing, one, two, three, four, pedaling, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. That was a good one, release. That was a good one. I can feel it already, it's becoming more stronger. It's pinching better. The science, I'm told and have learned, that there are pieces of the brake pads that are coming off. Micro pieces of the asbestos, or whatever your pad is made out of, are coming off. Of course, you know, like sandpaper. They're scraping, so there's pieces that are coming off, microscopic pieces, and they're going onto the brake rotor. So the pores, almost like skin pores, right? The pores of the rotor are getting clogged, that's a good word, with these microscopic pieces of the brake pad. And it provides a nice surface for the pad to use for all future braking purposes. So we're scraping off the pad when we're using it. It's filling up the pores of the rotor, and they're becoming, you know, one. They're understanding each other and they're reading each other and they're becoming unified. It's pretty exciting science. Okay, where am I? Number six? I think I'm done with six. This is a good speed and not much traffic. Okay, here we go. Number seven, rear brake. Ready and starting now, starting, pressing, pressing, pressing harder because of the tricycle. Pressing, I'm still pressing, I didn't let go of it, but I had to press harder because he was veering in. I'm still pressing it now, and release, yeah. That's number seven, right? If you lose count, which I probably will, somewhere in the 8 to 10, what I've learned is good enough. That's a seven. Here's another one. Ready. And number eight. Press, 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 press. I'm pedaling. Press, 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 press. Still pedaling. Pressing, pressing. And release. That's number eight. I think that's good enough. Let's go to the, let's trans- transfer to the front brake now. But hey, by the time we get to Marikina Riverbank, we might be ready for some faster speeds, actually. And then we'll do some more sets. So if we can get our moderate speeds finished now on the way, that'll be good. We just have the fast ones later. Okay, let's go to our front brake. With the front brake, you need to be careful because, of course, if you hit your front brake, and I learned this from experience when I was a teenager on my first bicycle in the 70s, that if you hit the front brake too emergency-ish on a brand new bike, it might actually grab and you're gonna go over the front, which I did, and I broke my collarbone as a result. Woo! I went over the front of that bicycle because I hit the front brake too intensely. To prevent that momentum problem, you can just lean back farther on the seat like this. Especially if you're going down an intense hill, you get back here, put some weight on the back of your bike, and that'll help you better to prevent flying over the front, especially on an intense downhill. Get your weight towards the back of the bike so it doesn't lift up. Okay, we're gonna start on the front brake pretty soon here. Ready? And let's start now. Ready? And press, 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 press. Pressing, pressing. I'm still pedaling. Pressing, 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 pressing. And release. Well, I can tell that it's brand new because there's no stopping. There's no bite yet. The bite of the brake comes from the braking in of the brake. So if you want your brakes to really bite, you need to brake them in first and get those rotors, the pores, P-O-R-E-S, of the rotor filled up with those microscopic metal shavings. Okay, we're gonna go for a second cycle. Front brake, ready, and press. 2, 3, 4, pedaling. 2, 3, 4, pressing. 2, 3, 4, and release. Okay. Whew. Seems insane using your brake and pedaling at the same time, but that's how to do it. You're supposed to do a similar activity even for cars, and honestly, I've never done it. Never on a car when I've changed my brakes. You just go out and start driving, you know? So, I know, bad on me. Okay, what was that? That was number 2, I think. We're gonna take a right up here and look for a spot for 3. We're heading towards Marikina right now. I'm gonna take a right, get ready. We're gonna start our number 3 almost immediately. And number 3, pressing, pressing. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Pressing and braking. Pressing and, not braking, pressing and pedaling. And release, okay. That's number 3, I think. Okay, going for number 4, let's do it now. Ready, and press the front brake. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Releasing. Nicey, nicey release. That was number 4. Let's go for 5. Ready and press. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, eight, nine, release. Let's go for number six. I'm on fire, yeah. Ready and press the front brake. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Okay, what is that? Seven. We'll do one more. Ready and press. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and release. Whew. Okay. We gotta switch lanes. Here's a good place. Let's see if we can get in at least one fast cycle on the rear brake. Pick up some speed. Ready. And one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Woo! Wow. That's like pedaling with resistance. Reminds me of an indoor exercise bike where your power increases and resistance increases, but your speed is seemingly getting slower. Okay, we're gonna go left here. We're gonna take a right here. This will take us down to LTO Marikina, Land Transportation Office, and then eventually the riverbank area. I think what I'm gonna do, rather than bore you with the redundancy, I'll just do one or two fast ones, and then I believe you've got the idea. Oh. This is the section we're gonna do some cycles. There's a drain up here that is a pretty big bump though, so it's not perfectly smooth. But I actually have a video on the Marikina Riverbank route where I videoed, here's that drain. I videoed this whole route with almost no editing. Okay, let's do a couple cycles here on our rear brake first. Ready? And go. Press. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Whew, boy, it's hard.
Hi.
That's a two, I believe. So I got about seven or eight more. I'm gonna do a couple front breakers and then we'll do some more for them later after logging off. Okay, let's pick up some speed here. Ready? And front brake. Press. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Wow. Whew. That's a good exercise. It's like doing ladders. Okay, get ready for a fast one on the front. It's fast move. Let's do it up here. Oh, these kids. Stay ready and go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Whew. That's it. We're just gonna do 8 more fronts and 8 more rears, and we're gonna skip the big downhill mega speed one, and I'll be satisfied with that. Okay, so I believe you got it, right? Just for review. 8 to 10 slow on the front, 8 to 10 slow on the rear, 8 to 10 fast on the front, 8 to 10 fast on the rear, and then one good downhill if you still have energy left over. And on that big downhill, go ahead and make half of the hill your front brake and half of the hill your rear brake. And never come to a complete stop during the activity so that that debris does not build up on one spot on your rotor, but you want it to be spread out across the rotor, filling in all of those pores equally and evenly, okay? Let's take a little break here. I don't know if you're gonna see anything, but we'll take a little look here. Yeah, I can tell. I can tell there's been some activity here. Can you see it? I don't know if that's, yeah, that's just, oops, wrong side. I can see it being activated here on the rear brake. Okay, that's it. That's how you brake in your rotors and your, a little bit of lightheadedness. That's how you brake in your rotors and your brake pads. Okay, have a good day.